The making of Gagawaka was based on using found objects, on often using trash as a starting point of creativity. You could say there was a violence here, because if you use materials like soles of shoes or dirty leather and make a dress out of it, then there is an anti-aesthetic in it. Once I work on trashed objects or garments, each of them then become part of a total configuration as I select them. Things like red bras, they could be bandages, they could be discarded X-ray film. These then acquire a certain form, they acquire a certain aesthetic, they acquire finally a sense of beauty. When you see a mannequin in a shop window, you don't look at it twice. You certainly don't think about it. But here it takes its place like a piece of sculpture. And even the attributes of the mannequin, which is neutral, are transformed, and each one has a certain character. Looking back from Gagawaka to Postmortem, I would then retrieve certain elements from the garment itself to be able to then partially dress another figure. This use of a partial garment, or the splitting of a garment into just being worn with completely different elements, gave me a freedom in being able to make different fully sculpted objects. Yet in this bringing back, some of the earlier aesthetic of Gagawaka also returns, but with the freedom that finally it's an art object and it's not something a human being will wear. What seems a cruel act interests me as it allows me to bring it to a space of poetic beauty, where if there is pain, there is also the registering or marking of something that would be a visual delight. I think this is what connects to the earlier work. So it's not as if one follows the earlier, or that Postmortem is destroying or dismantling everything that there was in Gagawaka, but that both are deeply connected in one sense. Whether you use the word existential, or the condition of man, or the times that we live in, which Gagawaka to a great extent refers to, but it also camouflages, because after all, a garment is about covering the body and having delight and pleasure in the surface, whereas in Postmortem, I can raise many questions about the human condition. This relationship of inside-outside, of breakdown and exposure, has a long tradition in the practice and history of modern art. Once you open a body, that is, when you do a postmortem, what are you looking for? You're looking for the inside of the body, but a fiberglass mannequin is hollow from inside. So I found these fascinating-looking medical objects, medical educational tools, which I've inserted into a hollow figure, as in acrobat, where the inside with the medical objects and the mannequin's exterior get integrated into one sculpture. This constant shifting to different meanings informs a lot of my work, and I hope this becomes apparent in the spirit of holding these shows together.